We are back and you're watching News Channel 3's Live at 9. We are well into the new year, but are you still managing to stick with those resolutions that you made? Well, one author and lifestyle expert believes the key to keeping them is fun.
Okay, yes. I guess that makes sense. Yes. Donna Bozzo literally wrote the book on fun, and she's joining us this morning to talk about giving yourself a chance to stick to those good resolutions that you've made and have a good time doing it. Welcome to Live at 9.
Thank you.
What are the statistics? We all make them, but how quickly do we give up on our resolutions?
It's a tough game. According to Forbes magazine, 25% of us are bagging these resolutions by the end of the month.
Now we're halfway through. 25%? That's a ton of people.
Yeah, and only like 8% actually make their goals. So my key is just to add a big dose of fun to everything, and I think that's the key to like keeping it going all year long.
I'm guessing the number one is weight loss, eating better, that sort of thing. But then we also have this component of families being so separated now in their own house. We're all on our devices, so there's a way to bring fun back to the family dinner.
Absolutely. There's a bulletproof plan. I am telling families everywhere. I love Home Chef meal kits. Now you can pick these up at Kroger's or order them online. It's everything you need to make a healthy dinner. Everything's fresh. It comes pre-measured. They're designed by professional chefs.
So the kids can help.
And the kids can help. So they're in the kitchen helping you make dinner while, you know, you're like getting ready and you're talking about your day.
And how do they taste?
And they taste delicious. Like I said, they're designed by professional chefs, so they're better than anything that I can conjure up at home. And they're very carb and calorie conscious. So many of the meals are under 600 calories a portion.
Okay.
And I like this. I'm not making a big pot of spaghetti and going back for seconds. They're portion control. What you get is what you get, right?
Yeah, what if you're still hungry at the end of it? But that's
well, I think that if that's your healthy eating is your goal.
You also have a what's this? What's
okay,
I see Legos?
Lots of people like to write down their goals, calendars, journals. Well, I love this. So every time you make a step toward that big stubborn goal, you go ahead and you reward yourself. Now you can use marbles. I'm using leftover Christmas candy, Legos, anything works. So you know, you go ahead and you work out that day.
Okay.
Go ahead and you put something in there. You know, you're like seeing your goal build and you're like actually rewarding yourself. And it's really fun for kids too. Maybe every time they clean their room or whatever their goals are, they put a little marble, a little Lego.
And what about the gummy bears here?
Well, I mean, make it fun, right?
The gummy bears too?
You could use anything you have around the house.
Like if you do chocolate almonds and then you eat the almonds. So if you're trying to lose weight, maybe stick with the Legos.
I think Legos are probably a little bit more bulletproof on that.
All right, let's move on over here. You got a few other things.
So those stubborn goals are hard to reach. So I say make some silly goals too. So maybe it's see more movies with the family this year, or take more selfies, or you know, go ahead and play more family games, or you know, learn to dance the cha-cha. Something that's easy that you can master, and then while you're doing this fun goal, you know, you have a little more oomph to get to those stubborn
selfies.
Resolutions.
Now that's interesting.
That is interesting.
I'm still trying to perfect my selfie.
How do you convince kids today have so many options? So how do you convince them, like if your goal is to have more family fun, how do you convince them? Because your resolution might not be their resolution. So now you're trying to keep a good resolution for yourself, but also pulling another person in. How do you convince your kids?
Well, you know, you just have to get on board as a family. And these are our family goals. So maybe everybody kind of chooses them. And, you know, you write down, like, maybe your idea of family fun isn't their idea of family fun. So everybody maybe writes on a slip of paper what they like to do, fill it up in like some sort of a vase or, you know, bucket, like a bucket list. And then, you know, when it is Saturday afternoon and all of a sudden you have a break in the action, pick something out. Let the kids be a part of it. I think when the kids are a part of it, they're on board.
So share the ideas and then carry them out.
Well, actually have them come up with some of the ideas.
Yeah.
So it's not just all what you want to do, go to the art museum. Maybe they really want to go, you know, try out something else.
Yeah.
So everybody gets a chance to do what they find fun. Everyone has a different flavor of fun.
This is about fun.
Every time they have a good idea, something they want to do, they can put it in your thing. There you've combined two into one.
All right, Donna, like you've helped us out in a big way today. Thank you very much.
Good luck, everyone. Happy New Year.
We'll let you know come February whether we've kept any of our goals.
All right.
I'll be checking in for sure.
Please do.